Let's get right into the Word of God today. I'm going to ask you to turn to Luke chapter 4. And we're going to read a passage that's familiar. We read it, I'm sure you've read it plenty of times yourself. And it's concerning the temptation of Jesus in the wilderness. Amen. And it's in Luke chapter 4. And you'll also find it in Matthew chapter 4 as well. And so there may be an occasion, amen, where you want to read both, amen, so that you can get the most out of the passages, amen. But today we're going to focus on Luke, the Gospel of Luke chapter 4, and we're going to begin reading at verse number 1. If you have it, say amen, I have it.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Wait for somebody else to give it to you. Amen. Luke chapter 4.
Amen.
Amen.
Beginning at verse number 1. Let's read it. Let's look at it together. It says, "And Jesus, being full of the Holy Ghost, returned from Jordan and was led by the Spirit into the wilderness, being 40 days tempted of the devil. And in those days he did eat nothing. And when they were ended, he afterward hungered. And the devil said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, command this stone that it be made bread. And Jesus answered him, saying, It is written, that man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word of God. And the devil, taking him up into a high mountain, showed unto him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time. And the devil said unto him, All this power will I give thee, and the glory of them. For that is delivered unto me, and to whomsoever I will, I give it. If thou therefore wilt worship me, all shall be thine. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Get thee behind me, Satan. For it is written, Thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and him only shalt thou serve. And he brought him to Jerusalem, and set him on a pinnacle of the temple, and said unto him, If thou be the Son of God, cast thyself down from hence. For it is written, He shall give his angels charge over thee to keep thee, and in their hands they shall bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against a stone. And Jesus answering said unto him, It is said, Thou shalt not tempt the Lord thy God. And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed from him for a season." Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. Let's pray over the word that we just read. Father, to you we give praise and thanks for the scripture that was just read into our hearing and into our hearts. We pray now that the Holy Spirit will come and to lead us and guide us into the truth of your word. Father, in the name of Jesus, we bless you, O God, because we are thankful for that which we have already received by faith, because we believe, God, that you shall speak a word that we need to hear at this very hour. Father, I thank you that your people are prepared to receive the word. Father, I thank you, God, that you shall use me for your glory, O God, to speak your heart. And Father God, I humble myself under your hand that you may be exalted in the place. And Father God, we call it done by faith. All of the great things that shall transpire here as your word goes forward. Father, we thank you now for transformation, change, restoration, and renewal. And we give you the praise for it all. In Jesus' name,
amen.
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 Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We just read Matthew, I should say Luke chapter 4. 1 through 13, the temptation of Jesus Christ in the wilderness. Amen. And this account is also in Matthew chapter 4. Our title today, amen, glory to God, is Overcoming Your Demons. Yeah, that's right. I'm going to say it again. Overcoming Your Demons.
Amen.
Amen.
See, this is a good title just to begin with, right? Because God letting us know right now, okay, all pretension is out of this place right now.
Amen.
Exactly. So, see, listen, why don't we do this right now? Why don't we make it easy? Because we're only like a minute into the sermon. Why don't we do this right now? If overcoming your demons is something that offends you, we're going to wait. We're going to give you 30 seconds to leave. Amen? Mm-hmm. We're going to give people 30 seconds to turn off their internet.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Mm-hmm.
In fact, we're only going to give you 20. We got to move on. Amen? Because come on, somebody. We're going to be real in here today.
Amen.
Right?
Amen.
How many of you know that God can't help you if you try to fake it? I'll tell you one thing. One of the worst things I've ever heard in the church, and I've heard a lot of bad things in the church, but one of the worst things I've ever heard in the church was fake it until you can make it.
Uh-uh.
God doesn't like a faker.
That's right.
You got to be real with God.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Mm-hmm. Don't fake that you believe God. Don't fake that you have an anointing.
Yeah.
Don't fake that you have wisdom.
Yeah.
You can't fake it until you can make it with God. You have to be real with God.
Amen.
You got to be real with God.
Amen.
And so that means that sometimes you have to acknowledge your shortcomings, your failings, and your faults.
Mm.
Because only then can God reach down his loving hand and help you.
That's right.
But as long as you and I stay in denial, then we are keeping God from intervening in our lives and changing what needs to be changed.
Exactly.
So we're not even brought no pretense in here today, amen.
Praise
in
God.
Fact, no pretense in here anytime.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Amen.
Glory to God. We serve a real God, so what should we be?
Real
people.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes.
We serve a real God, so we should be real people.
That's right.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Overcoming what? Your demons.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's personal, you say what? Overcoming?
My demons.
Amen. Not that you lay ownership to them, but you understand you got some stuff that you need to deal with.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And we use Luke chapter 4, verses 1 through 13 as our background. I got to tell you something. This word, I need you to pray for me. I know you always pray for me and pray for the word. I say that by faith.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
I say that by faith.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yes.
Amen.
Because even if you're not, I say it by faith because I call things that be not. That's the way they work, right?
Amen.
So I know you're praying
for
the word. Amen. But I have to do it because this is a word that is being spoken even as I speak.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Because all week long I was working on something else.
Mm-hmm.
But I just knew. I had it, man. I had it.
Mm.
And this is what happened. Sister Fannell and I last night watched a movie. It was called Mr. Church.
Mr. Church.
And it had Eddie Murphy in it. And I was a little skeptical by both the title and the fact that Eddie was in it. Now listen, I love Eddie Murphy. I like Eddie Murphy.
Mm-hmm.
And but sometimes, you know, some of the things he's in is a little bit not to my liking.
Mm-hmm.
It's a little too hammy, too corny, too silly. So I didn't know what to expect from this movie called Mr. Church.
Mm-hmm.
But it turns out Eddie was really, really good.
Mm.
He really put in a good performance, I think. I'm not any critic or anything, but I thought he was really good.
Mm-hmm.
And he played, and he was the title, he was the character whose name is in the title. He was Mr. Church.
Mm-hmm.
And this Mr. Church was graceful, he was talented, I mean, he could cook. You know, he was like a master chef. He could cook, he could play the piano, he was well-read, you know, he read a lot of books, he was kind, he was patient, he was loving, he was giving, understanding, he was soft-spoken, he was good-natured, he was good!
Mm-hmm.
And his name was Mr. Church.
Yep.
But yet Mr. Church, as it turns out, was dealing with some demons. And that's not what the story was about necessarily, but it was definitely part of all of the complexity of his character.
Mm-hmm.
He was dealing with some demons, and it just unfolded where sort of like three quarters of the way through the movie you found out.
Mm-hmm.
Because he was very protective of his privacy.
Mm-hmm.
And it turns out that he has some demons that were born of an abusive relationship with his father. And hurtful words spoken by his father. And so he had these demons from his past that were haunting his present in the form of alcoholism.
Mm-hmm.
And if we're honest, and if we walk in honesty and humility, we can look at a person like Mr. Church and relate. Because on some level, especially publicly, we're pretty good,
mm-hmm.
right? You dress nice, you smell nice, you drive nice, you talk nice, amen? You look nice, right? You speak nice words, you got a nice job, a nice house, nice car, nice lawn, nice dog, nice goldfish. Everything about you is nice and pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm telling you this, I don't care how nice we are on the outside, every one of us, like Mr. Church, are battling some demons.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Yeah.
Every one of us. And it's an interesting name, this movie, Mr. Church. Mr. Church. It's an irony, right, that somebody who goes by the name of Mr. Church would be battling demons. But I don't care if you Mr. Church, Miss Church, Mrs. Church, or Mr. and Mrs. Church. You still have some demons in your life.
Yes, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Some demons that you're battling, amen. And so, you know, on the one hand, it seems like demons and church don't go together. But the truth of the matter is, if you want to find some demons, perhaps the first place you should look is in the church.
That's
not
right.
Because the church is demon-possessed, but because demons hate God.
Yeah.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Satan hates God.
That's right.
Hates everything associated with God.
That's right.
Hates the plan of God.
Yeah.
Hates the works of God. And hates the people of God.
That's true. That's
so
true.
If you want to find demons, watch in the church and around people who are living for God.
Mm-hmm.
I was about to say church folk, but I wasn't going to say church folk.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not going to say church folk. But demons hate everything that's associated with God.
Yeah.
He will do everything in his power to oppose God, which means he will do everything in his power. If you are a child of God, he's going to do everything in his power to oppose you.
Yeah.
That's why you don't have to look too far to find a demon. Find a person of God, and the demon's going to be there.
Wow.
You're going to say, you got to be kidding me. Come on now. God's on them. Yes, God is on them. But even Paul said, he said, I discovered a law. He said, every time I want to do good, evil is always present.
Yeah.
Is that what he said?
Yes.
If you read the book of Job, you understand that when the sons of God came before God on a particular day,
yes.
Who was there with him?
Satan
was right there with him. Come on, somebody.
That's right.
See, sometimes we act like, you know, you walk in, and does the Spirit of God walk in with you? Oh, yes, it does. But Satan is nipping at your heels, amen?
Yeah.
Like a chihuahua on steroids, amen? That's trying to mess you up.
Yes, yes. That's true.
Amen. But we can overcome him, amen?
Amen.
Because the good news is that God is greater than Satan and all his demons.
Amen.
Amen. Because Satan and all his demons, they ain't nothing but they are created beings.
Yes, they are.
God created. Now somebody says God created Satan. No, but watch this. Let's do this. Can we turn in our Bible a couple times today? Is that all right?
Amen.
Amen. Let's do that. Let's turn to Ezekiel chapter 28. Because see, Satan is nothing but a created being. And God is greater than Satan. Amen.
Yes,
and so as children of God, just because we are under attack, and we are under attack by Satan, how many of you know that?
Amen.
Right? Mm-hmm. Amen. We are under attack. And somebody said, well, how are we under attack? Demons are real, y'all. Amen.
Yes, they are.
Amen. It's not just some movie thing. That's why we gotta be careful. My wife and I, amen, every time we see these movies, amen, they make these movies about all these spiritual forces and these evil things. We like look at each other and go, man doesn't know what they're messing with. Making all these crazy movies about these evil spirits and all this kind of, it's like, you better leave that stuff alone. It's real enough. You don't have to be making some fake movie about it.
Exactly.
You need to spend your time really fighting against the evil forces that are in this world.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Evil forces like, well, I don't believe in that demon and angels and stuff. Well, okay, just because you don't believe it doesn't mean it's not true.
Exactly.
This word of God lets us know. Do you know that demons play itself out in all kinds of ways, right? Addictions, mm-hmm. right?
Mm-hmm.
Insecurity, guilt,
mm-hmm.
shame, jealousy, unforgiveness, pride, fear. Demonic forces are behind all that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
Contentions, amen. People fighting against each other, hostility. All this stuff is grounded in Satan and all his evil work.
Mm.
Every time you and your spouse have an argument, Satan is the one that instigated that
mm-hmm.
thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. He instigated that thing. Yeah. Amen. He started whispering in your ear about how she spoke back to you.
Mm-hmm.
You're the man of the house. You're not supposed to talk to you like that. Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, you're going, I'm the man of the house. You ain't supposed to talk to me like that.
Mm-hmm.
See, God didn't give that to you. Yeah. God doesn't talk like that, telling you, you're the man of the house. She don't talk to you like that.
Mm-hmm.
God speaks things like forgiveness,
mm-hmm.
amen, yes. and forbearance,
yeah.
and grace, and mercy. He doesn't speak like, oh, you need to tell her. Satan is at work. Let's look at this in Ezekiel. We went to Ezekiel chapter 28, right?
Yeah.
Let's look at verse number 11. We're going to read a little bit. Moreover, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, Ezekiel writes, Son of man, take up a lamentation upon the king of Tyrus, and say unto him, Thus saith the Lord God, Thou sealest up the sun. Full of wisdom and perfect in beauty. That term right there, let's stop for a second. Thou sealeth up the sum is really saying you are complete.
Mm.
Amen. That you essentially are you are put together so well, you are perfect.
Mm-hmm.
Full of wisdom and perfect in beauty.
Mm-hmm.
Thou hast been, watch this, thou hast been in Eden, the garden of God. Every precious stone was your covering. The sardius, topaz, and the diamond, the beryl, the onyx, and the jasper, the sapphire, the emerald, and the carbuncle and gold. The workmanship of thy tabrets and of thy pipes was prepared in thee in the day that thou wast what? Created.
Mm-hmm.
Thou art the anointed cherub that covereth, and I have set thee so. And thou wast upon the holy mountain of God. Thou hast walked up and down in the midst of the stones of fire. Thou wast perfect in thy ways from the day that thou was created,
mm-hmm.
till iniquity was found in thee.
Mm.
By the multitude of thy merchandise, they have filled the midst of thee with violence, and thou hast sinned. Therefore I will cast thee as profane out of the mountain of God, and I will destroy thee, O covering cherub, from the midst of the stones of fire. Thine heart was lifted up because of thy beauty. Thou hast corrupted thy wisdom by reason of thy brightness. I will cast thee to the ground. I will lay thee before kings that they may behold thee. Thou hast defiled the sanctuary by the multitude of thine iniquities, by the iniquity of thy traffic. Therefore will I bring forth a fire from the midst of thee. It shall devour thee, and I will bring thee to ashes upon the earth in the sight of all them that behold thee, and all they that know thee among the people shall be astonished at thee. Thou shalt be a terror, and never shalt thou be any more. How many of you know this is a descriptive passage? It's a descriptive passage of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. talking about Satan being the anointed cherub. Amen. A cherub is a heavenly creature. Amen. He was anointed. Amen. He was in the Garden of Eden. Perfectly complete. Mm. He was beautiful.
Yeah.
Beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Covered with precious stones all over the place.
Right.
Amen. The anointed cherub. Amen. He was in the holy mountain of God. He was created, but he was in the mountain of God. Walked up and down the mountain of God. Amen. It says here that you know that he had tabrets and pipes, which is just another word, a way of saying, amen, that he really was created to play music. He was perfect in the way, in all his ways from the day that he was created, it says in verse 15, until iniquity was found in me. Mm. What was that iniquity? It says that he sort of got caught up on himself.
Yeah.
His heart got lifted up because he was beautiful.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He got corrupted because he thought he was so wise.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
And then God said, you got to get on up out of here.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, and I'm going to destroy you.
Yes.
And so Satan's fate is sealed. Amen. Why? Because he essentially rebelled against God, the God who created him. He got caught up in his beauty. Uh-oh. He got caught up in his talents. He got caught up in his wisdom. How many of you know that when people do that today, that they are operating, and if it happens that we've done it, we're operating in the spirit of Satan.
Yeah, that's true.
When you get caught up in pride and think you're better than the next man, you think you're better than the next woman, all you're doing is showing that Satan's got a grip on you.
Amen.
Because it is that very attitude that sealed his fate as far as God's concerned. He said, I'm going to destroy you. And the world's going to hear from you no more.
Yeah.
Oh, the clock is ticking on Satan. That's why he's going crazy in the earth.
Exactly.
And he's trying to do all these things. And he's trying to take as many people with him. Because misery loves company. And he's trying to get more and more people to go with him. But how many of you know he's not getting you? Amen.
Amen. Amen.
He's not getting you. He's not getting me. Satan, get thee behind me.
Yeah.
Amen. I'm not falling for your scheme. We are not ignorant of his devices.
Yes,
amen.
That's right. That's
amen.
Right.
And the worst thing anybody can do is to pretend that he doesn't exist.
Huh.
Mm. Amen. But he's a created being.
Yes.
Now let's turn back to not back to Luke, but let's toward the book of Genesis. Let's go to Isaiah. Let's look at another passage there. I believe, amen. Can I say this? And if you agree with it, then I will really feel good about it. If you don't, I'll be all right. But I just feel the need to take my time, amen?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
But we're not going anywhere. Mm-hmm. And I don't mean that in the sense like you're going to be here all day. We're not going anywhere. Mm-hmm. I'm just saying, amen. If we start now, we can pick up. If God bless us to come again next time, we can pick up again next time. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather take our time and get some stuff than to rush through it and miss it.
Exactly.
How about that? Amen.
Exactly.
Amen. Right. So we're going to take our time here today.
Mm-hmm.
All right, we're in Isaiah chapter 14. Let's look at verse number 12 in Isaiah 14. How art thou fallen from heaven, O Lucifer, son of the morning? How art thou cut down to the ground, which did weaken the nations? But thou hast said in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of God. I will sit also upon the mount of the congregation in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds. I will be like the Most High. Yet thou shalt be brought down to hell, to the size of the pit.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
See, this is Lucifer. Amen. Again, you see the spirit of Satan so caught up on himself.
Exactly.
You see how many times I will do this. I will do that. I.
Wow.
Again, amen. When folks talk about themselves and are caught up on themselves and say I. That's the spirit of Satan.
Yes, it is.
Because the spirit of pride and of self-centeredness and all those types of things. God wants us to be humble.
Yes.
Amen. He says, think not more highly of yourself than you ought.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen.
Paul said, but for the, he said, by the grace of God, I am what I am. In other words, he was giving all credit to God. Whatever I am, it's because of God's grace.
Yeah.
How many people can say the same thing?
Yeah.
Praise God, you're the supervisor, but it's by the grace of God. Praise God, you got all these things going on, but it's by the grace of God. Amen. Give God the praise.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen. Amen. Without God, I'm nothing. Oh, wretched man that I am.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Amen. But see here, Lucifer, and we know, we hear the term Lucifer, and we immediately think devil, don't we? Lucifer, because we think that's such an evil name. But how many of you know that that name Lucifer actually is a Latin word that's a designation for the morning star? It literally means light bearer. He was a bearer of light. Remember we saw it in Ezekiel, right? He was perfect.
Yeah.
He was a bearer of light. But he got caught up on himself.
Yeah.
Wow.
He got caught up on himself, and then he got cast out of heaven. But watch this. Now we're going to turn to Revelation. We're turning in our Bible today.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. It's the word of God that will save our souls. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Let's look at Revelation chapter 12. And let's look at verse number 3. It says, and there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, a great red dragon, having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his heads. Watch this. And his tail drew down the third part of the stars of heaven and did cast them to the earth. And the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered for to devour her child as soon as it was born. How many of you know this is the depiction, amen, of Satan, and the child who was being born was Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
But watch this. It says that Satan, the dragon, took her. In fact, if you look at verse number 9, it says, and the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil. Mm-hmm. So it makes it plain to us, right, that dragon is the devil.
Mm-hmm.
And what did he do? He took his tail and gathered up the third of the stars of heaven and cast them down to earth with him.
Yes.
See, those are all the fallen angels that are now demonic forces that are in the earth.
That's right.
He took a third of them, and I don't know how many there were, but a third of them, and cast them down.
Mm-hmm.
And so Satan ain't operating by himself. He has
a whole
horde of demons in his evil arm.
That's right.
Yes.
That's right.
That's funny. You know what they're doing?
Mm.
They are looking to destroy the things of God, the works of God, the people of God.
That's true.
Satan does what? He looks to kill,
to steal,
and to destroy.
That's right. That's right.
And he has a horde of demonic forces, fallen angels. In fact, you don't have to turn there, but I feel my finger coming on. My turning finger. In Jude chapter 6, Jude talks about the angels which kept not their first estate, but left their own habitation.
Mm-hmm.
See, there were some angels that didn't keep their first estate, which was in heaven.
Mm-hmm.
They left because Satan, you know, drew them down.
Wow.
A third of them. And where are they now? They're here on this earth.
Wow.
Causing havoc. The prince of the power of the air. How does Satan operate? He's operating through his demonic forces.
Yeah.
And some of them are assigned to your life.
Yeah.
Wow.
I'm not saying that. I'm just saying the truth. Because they're assigned to mine too.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen. And watch this. And the more you live for God, the more a threat you become to the kingdom of darkness, that even more demons get assigned to you.
That's true. That's true. That's true.
Listen, if you really are living for God now more than you ever have, you should have more demons assigned to your life than you ever have. Or you got stronger ones assigned to you.
Yeah.
Because there was a time Satan could send a little demon up to you and he'd trip you up. Now you step on that demon's head. You kick that one to the curb. See, some of them demons, they can't bother me. Oh, he said, okay, I got to send a stronger demon.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know demons have hierarchies?
Yes.
Yes, they do.
We battle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. You know what? There's levels of demons.
Yes. Uh-huh. Amen.
You know how they used to say in the church, they're probably still saying, right? New levels?
New devils.
New devils, right? Right? You get to a new level in God, you're going to get a new devil. I'm walking in great anointing and power. Praise the Lord. Well, okay, because you got a new devil.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Yeah. Who been assigned to you to try to take you out, because you are stronger. You are more committed. You are more dedicated. So it's going to take more to get you off your post.
Yes, yes.
And so the devil knows that, so he don't keep sending little small demons that you can beat up. He sends even greater ones. Why we need to talk about this? Because listen, if you don't win the fight and overcome your demons, what's going to happen? Whether kill, steal,
destroy.
That's what's at stake. That's why church is no plaything, y'all. I don't know about you, I'm not playing about the word of God.
Amen.
Amen.
Huh? That's why I tell you from day one. Listen, I don't care how many people in here. If it's coming Sunday morning, I'm preaching.
Amen. Amen.
I'll preach to the chair. I'll preach to that drum set right over there.
Amen. 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 Yes.
If none of y'all show up, I will preach to the drum set.
Amen. Amen.
And I will expect the drum to say amen.
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 Why? Because I'm serious about the, and you're serious about the word of God. Otherwise, you wouldn't be here.
That's right.
You have other things you can be doing on Sunday morning.
Amen.
But you're serious about the word of God.
Amen. Yes.
And you know that you are in a battle. Amen. Amen.
Right.
So, you know, this is real. This is real. Demons are in this world. They're operating, and they're trying to take us out. Not just you, but I mean, just everyone.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Unbelievers? I don't know if you stand a chance. Except by the grace and mercy of God.
Yeah.
Right? We have the grace and mercy of God too, but we also have the weapons of God.
Yeah.
Right? The weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they're mighty through God to the pulling down the stronghold. We also have the armor of God that we can stand against the evil day. We have the word of God that we can use to slice up the traps of the enemy that he tries to set against us.
Amen.
In other words, we have some additional help. We have the spirit of the living God living on the inside of us. And yet and still, Satan ensnares us sometimes and traps us sometimes and trips us up sometimes and lays his hands on us sometimes.
Yeah.
But you know what? Them days are coming to an end.
Amen.
Amen. Yes. Yes. Them days are coming to an end. We're going to walk in more freedom and more power and more authority, because we're not pretending, amen. We're not tiptoeing through the tulips.
Exactly.
Right? Acting it, we're wearing rose-colored glasses, making it seem like everything is okay, and somehow people are our problem. Can we say it for the last time? People are not your problem.
Amen. Yes.
Amen.
Will we stop fighting people, please?
Yeah.
Come on, somebody. Mm-hmm. We finally are going to get Ephesians. We battle not
against flesh and blood.
Mm-hmm. Can we stop fighting each other and realize that the one we should be fighting is Satan and his evil cohort?
Amen.
Can we finally get that one?
That's right. That's right.
Amen. Amen. So we all have demons, amen. No one is immune, right?
That's right.
Now, I don't want anybody going home, hey, I got demons. No, not that way. But we got a battle against them is what I'm saying, amen. We have a battle against them, and we have to face up to them, amen. Mm-hmm. And if we face up to them, then we can deal with them. Right, but also we can embrace the truth of God's word that through the power of God we can defeat every single demon that comes up against
Amen.
Us and cast them out of our life. But we start first of knowing that we have that battle going on. And so if somebody, listen, do somebody a favor. If you come across someone, especially their child of God, who, you know, is in the church and living for the Lord, and they don't think they have any demons in their life and everything is good for them, can you let them know that's exactly how it all started? You know, being caught up on yourself. Can you let them know that that is the very spirit of Satan? Yeah. Can you let them know that Proverbs 6 and 18 says that pride goes before destruction and a haughty spirit before fall? Can you let them know? Can you let them know that? Can you let them know that when Jesus, in Mark chapter 16, as that chapter was closing, he said, this will be the signs of those who follow me. And the first thing he said was, they shall cast out demons. Right? What does that mean? That means demons are still operating. Amen. Yeah. It was the first thing Jesus said, they shall cast out demons. Before he said they shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover, he said they shall cast out demons. Why Jesus said that? And why did he say it first? Because it must be a priority. Because he understands that if you're going to follow him, Satan going to follow you.
Yeah, that's right.
Can I say that again?
Yeah,
if
you're
going to follow God, Satan going to follow you.
That's right. That's right.
You think Satan didn't come to you, didn't come to church with you today?
Sure.
Come on.
Amen.
You think Satan didn't come with you to church today? Why do you think that people fighting bigger in the midst of church? There's some people after church today, they're going to get in arguments in the parking lot at church. There's some people came in and got mad because somebody was sitting in their seat.
True.
Satan comes to church too, amen, because if you're following God, Satan following you.
Yeah.
Because why? Because he's trying to trip you up.
Amen.
Do you remember what Jesus told Peter? Peter was one of the most faithful disciples Jesus had. You know what he told Peter? You remember? Mm-hmm. He told me, he said, Satan had desired to sift you like wheat.
Yeah, that's true.
Right?
Yeah.
Satan desires to sift you like wheat.
Yes.
I mean, he want to bring you down. He want to mess with you, man. He want to shake you up and grind you up and pound you. Mm. So Satan is real, right? He's real. The demons are real. And so we're not going to pretend that we are somehow immune. Because wouldn't it be the height of arrogance to watch this? Wouldn't it be the height of arrogance? Didn't we just read Luke chapter 4? Wasn't Jesus, who was filled with the Spirit, led into the wilderness where he was tempted of Satan?
Yes.
But wait a minute, yes. You're saved. Who saved you? Jesus saved you. Oh, okay, so who's Jesus? He's my Lord and my Savior. Oh, he's your Lord. Jesus spoke and taught and said, the servant is not greater than his Lord.
Yeah.
So watch this. If your Lord and Savior was tempted by Satan, if your Lord and Savior had to deal with demonic forces, who, why in the world you think you don't? You're not greater than Jesus.
Right.
Jesus wasn't immune from Satan attacking him. Why would anyone think that Satan's not going to attack you?
That's right.
Why do you think Satan won't tempt you? He tempted Jesus. You greater than Jesus? No. So if Satan tempted Jesus, what? He's going to tempt me.
That's right.
So forget all this noise, amen, about, you know, that somehow you walk and you're immune. I plead the blood of Jesus over me every day. I put on the full armor of God every morning. I walk with the sword in my hand. I do all this. I don't care what. Satan still is coming after you.
That's right. That's right.
I'm not saying he's going to defeat you. I'm telling you, he won't.
Mm-hmm.
But know that he's coming.
Mm-hmm.
No. That he's coming. We talked about Job, didn't we?
Mm-hmm.
Right? We talked about Job. Satan came in the presence of the Son of God, and he said, yeah, I know Job is all up, right? Mm-hmm. But because you gave him so much.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that what he said?
Yeah.
You gave him so much. Skin for skin, he said, let me touch him, let me get him, right? But at first, he did what? He stole Job's businesses, destroyed him. What else did he do? He killed Job's children.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yesterday was Joseph's birthday, amen, would have been 24. Amen. And I said to myself, and I said to them, I know that Satan took killed Joseph.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's why I can't stand him.
Yeah.
Because he goes around trying to kill our children.
Yeah.
Come
yeah.
on, somebody. Yeah. He goes around trying to kill our children. Mm-hmm. He tries to kill them by accidents. He tries to kill them by drug overdose. He tries yeah. to kill them by getting into cults and all this other kind of nonsense. Mm-hmm. You know, you got kids out there sniffing all kinds of stuff.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm talking about all over the place, amen. So Donald Trump can stop with this nonsense about crime infested inner cities. There's crime in the suburbs. There's crime in the country. There's people out in the country doing drugs. There's people in the suburbs doing drugs. Don't just talk about drugs in the inner city. There's drugs all over this world.
That's right.
That's Satan right. don't care about geography. He's trying to get all our children. Amen. You can move to the suburbs if you want. Satan gonna follow you to the suburbs.
Exactly.
I gotta get out of here. There's nothing good here. Go out to the suburbs. Satan over there too.
Exactly.
Satan in the country. Satan's in the field. Satan's in the city. Satan's everywhere.
Exactly.
Well, no, let me take that back. Satan's not everywhere. Uh-huh. But he can only be one place at a time.
Exactly.
But he got his demons.
Oh,
yeah. Amen. I ain't giving Satan no glory. No, you don't. Yeah, you knew you had up there, didn't you, Satan? See, the Holy Spirit corrected me. You ain't everywhere.
Amen.
You can only be in one place at one time. That's only right. God yeah. is out of the presence. Praise God, the Holy Spirit. Satan ain't everywhere. He thought he got something on his head. Yeah. You ain't everywhere. That's why you need so many.
That's right.
That's why you need so many demons. Because you can only be in one place at one time.
Yeah.
Only my God is everywhere.
Yeah.
But what's the point? Evil is everywhere.
Yeah.
Right? So you're not escaping it by going to all these places. Amen. He took Job's children. He took Job's business. He even messed with Job's marriage.
Mm-hmm.
His wife started talking some nonsense. And Job had, they got into conflict. You talk like a foolish woman. You should curse God and die. Woman. You talking foolishness. He messed up Job's relationship with his friend. They came there talking nonsense to him. Well, you must have done something, Job, to deserve all this.
Mm-hmm.
That was all the work of Satan. And then he came and afflicted Job's body.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That was all the work of Satan.
Mm-hmm.
And his little evil demons. So this is what's going on, and this is what we're up against, amen? But again, we have the victory.
Yes.
You said, well, will you hurry up and get to it? No, I'm not going to hurry up and get to it. Because sometimes you have to understand the magnitude of the problem in order to really get serious about addressing it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
So we're not rushing anywhere. That's Satan saying, we're just going, come on, hey, hey, hey. Satan doesn't want you to get the word of God.
That's right.
You understand? Mm-hmm. When Jesus told the parable of the sower, he said what? The sower sows the word.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And he said, immediately after the word is sown, mm-hmm. Satan comes and tries to snatch that.
That's right. Exactly.
So he don't care. You can stay in church for 3 hours, but he's coming mm-hmm. in 3 hours and 1 minute to try to snatch that word. That
yeah,
he
exactly.
Got. So we know what we're going to do. We're going to make sure we lay a foundation. And you know you're not even in the Satan's devices. And when that word is sown in your heart, you're going to protect your heart.
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Guard thy heart with all diligence, for out of it flow the issues of life.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So he's at work. So how does Satan work? Right? We said Satan can't be everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But he has demons. He has a hierarchy of all these evil spirits. Right? One time I was feeling really bad about something, amen. You walk in this life and you fail, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Right? I mean, you fail. You did some things you do that you know better than doing.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes they're called mistakes. Sometimes it's called disobedience.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
True.
Mistakes mean you know, mistakes is like putting on a blue sock and a brown sock.
Mm-hmm.
That's a mistake. Lying is not a mistake. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Lying is not a mistake. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
Cheating on your wife, that's not a mistake.
Mm-hmm.
Kobe Bryant said, I fell into the mistake of adultery. No, brother. That was a mistake. You didn't fall into that.
Oh, yeah.
You didn't live up to your marriage vows, man. That was not a mistake. And then you didn't fall into it. It's like he walked along and then he said, whoa! How did I get here? And if you really fell, here's your problem. You stayed.
True.
You should at least gotten up.
True.
I fell into the mistake of adultery.
Jesus.
Go ahead, girl. Satan, all right, the demons are everywhere. And how does he work? Watch this. He got demons. You know, he got them going against people, right?
Mm-hmm.
Against you, against your family, against the church, against cities, against in states and in countries,
yeah.
In schools, in all kinds of institutions. He's operating in hospitals and in courthouses,
mm-hmm.
and through leaders and,
mm-hmm.
and through regular people and through bus drivers and through, you know, presidents and through music, through television, through drugs, through alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
He tries to touch all aspects of our culture and our society.
Mm-hmm.
And he tries to do what? To influence our minds. Because he really has limited power.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
But he's smart, he's cunning, he's crafty. Amen? And how does Satan work, right? He tries to use all these things, but also too, you know what Satan's big on? He's big on possession. Because
mm-hmm.
see, Satan needs a body.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yes, of course.
He needs a body to operate here in the earth.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And it could be a human body, it could be an animal body.
That's true.
And we've seen this. We've seen... I'm thinking about that thing in the movies, but I'm going to get back to the word. But it just reminded me of something. You remember that movie with Denzel Washington and John Goodman?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Where Haziel, or whatever the spirit's name was, mm-hmm. he would go from person to person as they walked down the street because they would touch.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And then he would go from person to person. See, that's real stuff. I know that was a movie, but that's real stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And you remember at the end of the movie when John Goodman was dying? That Denzel Washington thought he had taken him all the way out in the woods to kill him because there was nobody out there. And Denzel Washington was smoking a poison cigarette and he was going to die too. But what happened? There was a cat.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was just another body.
Mm-hmm.
Satan needs bodies.
Yeah.
He needs bodies. That's why when Jesus told that parable in Matthew chapter 12, he said, when the evil spirit is kicked out of a man.
Yeah.
He roams around in the dry places looking for another habitation.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And then he comes back to the same place, right?
Yeah.
And that place was unguarded.
Mm-hmm.
And what did he do? He brought seven more demons with him.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And they got back into that man, right?
Yeah.
Satan needs bodies. He needs possession. And watch this. Do you remember when Jesus, that man who was at the tombs,
mm-hmm.
and nobody would help him?
Mm-hmm.
And then Jesus took on those devils and said, what's your name? Legion, because we are many.
Yeah.
Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
And they asked Jesus, they said, listen, let us go into the swine and pigs. Remember?
Yeah.
Because
mm-hmm.
he knew, I'm about to get kicked out of this man, but I need another body. Let us go into the pigs.
Mm-hmm.
And they went into the pigs. And what happened immediately? Those pigs ran down the hill.
Yep.
Into the sea,
mm-hmm.
and were drowned.
Mm-hmm.
Why? Kill, steal, and destroy.
Mm-hmm.
That's all he, right? But he needs possession.
Wow.
That's why he tries to possess our mind.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce Meyer wrote a book. I didn't read the book, but I read the excerpt. The Battlefield of the Mind.
Mm-hmm.
He's trying to possess your mind. That's why the scriptures say, cast down imaginations and every high thing that exalts itself against the knowledge of God, and bring into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ.
Yeah.
Because if you don't, right? Yep. If you don't, then he will capture your mind. And if you capture the mind of a man, you capture the man. Mm. Because as a man thinketh in his heart, so is he.
Yep.
So it's a battle for your mind. He's trying to possess your mind. Don't act like I'm the only one. But there have been times that Satan will talk some dumb stuff to me.
Yeah, sure.
I'm telling you, I don't care what you think of me, I'm going to tell it. There's times I'm watching TV and Satan will tell me to throw the remote into the screen.
Yeah.
I'm just trying to tell you.
Yes, yes.
I know it's only me. That's all right. But I'm going to tell the truth and shame the devil.
Yeah.
But watch this. God ain't telling me that.
Exactly.
So where did that thought come from?
Exactly.
Throw the remote into the middle of the TV. You understand?
Yes.
I know.
Yes.
I'm telling you what, and see, this is how dangerous it can be. Now, that's small, but watch this. There have been times I've been in a store, and a police officer is like in Wawa or whatever, and they stand up there by the counter, and you know what I hear? Grab his gun.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody, I'm trying to tell you.
That's true. That's true,
man.
That's true.
And you wonder why some craziness jumps off out there in the street.
Exactly.
Because you think that man in Fort Lauderdale who went to his baggage claim and took his gun out and started loading up and shooting, you think Satan didn't tell him that?
Wow.
You think Satan didn't give him that thought?
Uh-huh.
His family even said he'd been hearing voices.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Come on, man.
Yeah.
Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Huh?
Wow.
Sometimes you wonder, how could that mother put her little child in that burning hot water? How do you think?
Wow.
Because Satan said that's what you should do.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
Wow.
You need to clean their mouth out with soap. Come on, somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Right? He wants to possess your mind, and he'll start telling you to do some crazy stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Now, some of that is extreme, but some of it is this. He'll tell the person who otherwise is living an upright life, take some money off the cash register.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Skim some money off the books in your, you know, you're the accountant at your job. Skim some money off the books. They won't know.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. He tries to possess, amen.
Yes.
He tries to tempt.
Yes.
Huh? He tries to tempt. He was doing it from the beginning, right? Back in the Garden of Eden, God said, "Of every tree of the garden, you can freely eat, except from the tree of the knowledge of good and evil."
Mm-hmm.
And then what he do? He comes slithering up in there, and he gonna say, "Has God really said?"
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We see voices.
Right. And do you understand what he did? And see, this is why it's so important. And we're going to get to it. He said, well, are we going to learn how to overcome it? Yeah, we're going to learn how to overcome it. But what did Paul say? We are not ignorant of his devices.
That's right.
So part of it is we're going to have to learn these devices. Because sometimes you think you're crazy. And I'm telling you now, you're not crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Satan just trying to put some crazy thoughts in your head.
That's true.
Amen.
That's true.
You're not crazy. You're a child of God. Amen. Huh? God has not given us a spirit of fear. Huh?
Yeah.
What? He doesn't give us a spirit of fear, but he's given us power and a sound mind.
Yes.
That's right.
You're not crazy. You got a sound mind.
Yeah.
But Satan comes in and says, has God really said? What are you trying to do? He's trying to tempt.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He tempted Jesus. We saw here in our scripture text.
Yeah.
Jesus comes there and Satan comes tempting him.
Mm-hmm.
For 40 days he's tempting him. It says in verse number 2, he was 40 days tempted by the devil. So Satan will use temptation. Satan will use lies. He'll lie against you. He'll lie against your husband. He'll have some Jezebel come up to you talking about what she did with your husband. She's lying. He's a liar. Jesus said, when he talked to the Pharisee, he said, your father the devil. He's a liar. He's been a liar from the beginning, and there's no truth in him. He lies. He tries to deceive us. He accuses us. The Bible says in Revelation 12 and 10 that he's an accuser of the brethren. That's why when people start accusing you, they're operating in the spirit of Satan. I tell people all the time, don't accuse folk. You may not know stuff. You may not know all the facts. There may be some things that happen and you don't know.
Amen.
Don't accuse people. You're operating in the spirit of Satan when you start accusing people of stuff. But he accuses you of things. This is what he does. So he tries to use all the things in our society. He tries to use the mediums and the media. He tries to use people and institutions. He tries to use music and television. He tries to use all these things.
Yeah.
All to get into your mind. Now somebody say, I can't believe you said you want to throw your remote at the TV. I can't believe it. But didn't he tell Jesus to throw himself off the mountain?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Amen.
Isn't that what he said?
Yeah.
And then he tried to use scripture.
Yeah.
He said, throw yourself off the mountain. Because scripture says that he'd have angels to keep you in all your ways.
Yeah.
But that scripture was against you, Satan. He was talking about he would keep me against the ways of you.
Yeah.
Throw yourself off the mountain. We see it in the Bible all the time. All these things that Satan calls suicidal tendencies. You need to kill yourself.
Wow.
Nobody cares about you. Where's that coming from? That's coming from Satan. I'm telling you, it's evil in this world.
There is.
Amen. But glory to God, we can overcome it.
Amen.
Yes. Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
And so we see Satan, amen. He tries to cause sickness, amen. He tries to cause death, amen. He tries to break up marriages. He tries to mess up our relationships, amen. And he walks around, as the Bible says, right? He walks around like a roaring lion, seeking whom he may devour, right? And even that just shows how much of a trickster he is. But he even uses the Bible in that. Oh! because in Proverbs 19 and 12, it says that the displeasure of the king is like the roar of a lion. Do you get that? The displeasure of the king is like the roar of a lion. Mm-hmm. So Satan, when he walks around, roars like a lion because he wants you to think that the king is displeased with
right.
you.
Yes.
He's such a trickster. He's such a deceiver. Because he's not a lion, but he's acting like one. Because he wants you to think that God the King is displeased with you. So you can go running and run right into his traps.
Yeah.
Wow.
So he's out there, y'all, amen. He's doing all kinds of things. And don't listen. Can I say this? Don't feel bad if you think bad thoughts. That's not a sin.
No.
It's giving in to them that's the sin.
Amen.
Yeah.
Right? Mm-hmm. You know how they say what? You can't keep a bird, you can't keep the birds from flying over your head, but you can't keep them from building a nest in your head.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So in other words, the thought's gonna come.
Right.
The question is whether the thought's gonna stay.
Right.
And then whether you act on those thoughts.
Yeah.
See, so when he tells, let me just clear this up right now. I have never thrown a remote into my television screen, okay? Let's just clear it up right now, okay? Anybody was wondering. That's why they got a new TV letter. No, it's not. That's not why we got the new TV. I'm not out there throwing remotes. Why? Because the thought can come, but it doesn't stay. Amen. Why? But you gotta be aggressive against that thing. You can't just let it sit there. You gotta come against it. Say, you are alive.
Yeah.
I plead the blood of Jesus over my mind right now. Amen. Cleansing me of every evil thought.
Yes,
I want somebody.
Right. Right.
Yeah, he can try to come, but I ain't gonna let him stay.
Amen.
Come on, come on. So listen, just because the thought comes, doesn't mean it gotta stay, doesn't mean you gotta entertain it. Mm-hmm.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. That's what got David in trouble. He went up to the roof, he saw Bathsheba, he started thinking.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
And he didn't let the thought go, amen. He kept thinking. And he kept thinking. And next thing you know,
it was there. Oh, boy.
Come on, somebody. We just gotta be real a minute. Amen. But you gotta get rid of that thing. You gotta be actively guarding your mind.
That's right.
So we're gonna close here, amen, on this. And we're gonna come back to the scripture next week.
Okay.
But we're gonna touch on a couple of things to sort of segue us. Be a segue for us to get deeper into this, right? Because we're not leaving this place talking about all these things Satan doing without saying this. We have the victory.
Amen.
So in case he thought that somehow we forgot the last part, we didn't.
Amen.
We have the victory.
Amen.
Amen. We have the victory in Christ Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
We have victory over Satan, but we need to follow Jesus' example. And Jesus gives us some of those examples in the scripture text we read today in Luke chapter 4. And we're just going to touch on this and put this here as a placeholder for next week. Number one, Jesus used the word of God. Right? He used the word of God. We're going to talk about more of that next week. Jesus used the word of God. He didn't try to defeat Satan using some homespun wisdom. He didn't try using some cliches that they were speaking in the synagogue. He went back to the word of God. Number one. Number two, Jesus, amen, was praying and fasting. So he used prayer, which includes fasting, which includes praise, which includes worship. Because how many of you know our prayer life should include all those things? Mm-hmm. Right? He used prayer. The other thing was, Jesus, the scripture tells us, right, he was empowered by the Holy Spirit. So he was relying on the Spirit of God and the power of the Holy Spirit and following his lead. Mm-hmm. And so here's the thing. How are we going to overcome the demons in our life? We're not going to do it any different way than Jesus does.
Amen.
We're going to do it by the word. Mm-hmm. We're going to do it through prayer. Mm-hmm. We're going to do it through the power of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen? And if Jesus started, this and next week we're going to start with the word. And if Jesus beat back Satan with the word, how many of you know we need to beat back Satan with the word?
Amen.
Right? Because this word is not some dead letter. Hebrews 4:12 says that the word of God is quick and powerful and sharper than any two-edged sword.
Amen.
That word quick means alive.
Yeah.
This word of God is alive. It's not some dead letter on a page. This word is alive. Right? And so how are we going to defeat it? We're going to, first things first, we're going to start with this word. Doesn't it always start with the word?
Yes.
Everything starts with the word of God.
Yes.
And us beating Satan, it starts with the word
of God.
We're going to pick up there on next week. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. Overcoming your demons. Amen. Amen. In our movie last night, amen, Mr. Church, I don't know if I can say, and since Fannell knows this has to be like, but we watched that movie last night, I went to bed already. I just had to put the finishing touches on the message that God gave me. I was good this morning, but damn, at least I thought. Then I woke up this morning, and God's like, nope. How many of you know, what did we get talking about trusting God on Friday?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This is a trusting God thing, amen. Mm-hmm. Amen. My mind all made up, but God said, touch not the lad. Sometimes you gotta know, God told you to give your son, your only son Isaac, and sacrifice him on Mount Moriah. And then you got the knife raised in your hand, you're about to plunge, and then a voice comes down from heaven and says, harm not the lad. Mm. What you gonna do? You gonna listen to what you heard already, or to what you're hearing from the Lord right now?
Wow.
You understand? But Lord, you gave me that word. Yeah, but what am I saying to you now? Glory to God. So I don't know what happened to Mr. Church last in the enemy. Well, I do know what happened to him. He died. Mm-hmm. And I don't know, again, because the story really wasn't about his demons or anything like that. But certainly, I think it was revealing and letting us know that you can be well put together on the outside. But listen, man, you got some stuff going on the inside of you. You got some experiences, you got from your past, you got some stuff from your present that is messing with you. Because Satan's trying to use those things against you, to derail you, to get you off the word of God. Mm-hmm. Ain't gonna work, amen? Amen. It's not gonna work, amen. We overcome him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of our testimony, amen? Amen, we are overcomers. Christ Jesus. So we'll pick up on this next week. Until then, let us rest on our feet and let's pray together. Amen. Praise God. Amen. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you today. Glory to God. We thank you for the word that you've spoken into our spirit, oh God. Father, we thank you that through the Lord Jesus Christ, through the Holy Spirit, and through your love, through your word, oh God, we have victory over every evil force that comes against us. Father, you said that we should not be ignorant of Satan's devices. You gave us your armor that we could stand against the wiles, the schemes of the devil, and that we can have the victory that is ours in Christ Jesus. Jesus paid such a price for us. We do not want to squander the victory that he has provided for us. So, Father, we come in humility of spirit. We come in obedience to your voice to live as you have commanded. The Holy Spirit says unto us now, be ye holy, for I am holy. Father, we are separated unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. And we follow you, but the voice of a stranger we will not follow. And so, Father, we thank you right now, hallelujah, that your spirit is strengthening us, giving us a firmer conviction, oh God, to submit ourselves unto you, to resist the devil, and watch him flee. Yes. And so, Father, we thank you, God, that we shall walk in even greater power as we heed your voice and the thing you are speaking unto us at this hour. Father, we ask now, God, that you will seal this word that you've already spoken in our hearts. Yes, hallelujah. Keep it from Satan, who would try to steal it right after the service is over.
Yes.
Father, we thank you that the Holy Spirit will continue to water this word, which is a precious seed in our spirit, and it shall bring forth a harvest of righteousness in our lives, all to the praise of your glory. Thank you for transforming us. Thank you for changing us from the inside out. And Father, we give you the praise for it in the name of Jesus. Victory is ours in Jesus' name. And we give you the praise. In his blessed name we say, amen.
Amen.
And amen. Again, amen. Glory to God. Amen. Praise God. You get ready to leave. Sister Leah's going to come and help us. I got an apology for you, Christian, because I forgot to pick up snacks.
Oops.
Got some goldfish, though. Look how he's looking at me. Yeah, you got to be kidding.